I watched your video about Bali.
Yes.
Yeah, the one that you say the widest island in Asia?
Question mark.
Question mark? With a question mark.
Yes, there's a question mark.
You're from Israel, right?
So I am Palestinian, Muslim.
You're Muslim. You're Muslim.
Muslim, Palestinian, Israeli.
But there's a controversy talking about that you don't have the religions.
But you know, Didi, if God forbid, let's say somebody says, I want to destroy Israel, then my family dies. Mm. You know, my Palestinian Muslim family dies. Right. So of course, I don't want Israel to be gone. I want Israel to succeed. And also I want Palestine to succeed because these are my people.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And close the door.
Ini podcast akan menimbulkan kontroversi yang luar biasa karena di depan saya ini ada Nozair Yassin yang kemarin juga diundang oleh Pak Sandiaga Uno ke menteri kita dan itu dirujak Pak Sandiaga Uno karena banyak sekali kontroversi. Nah, tapi
controversial.
Yeah, controversial.
No, not controversial.
Controversial.
No.
We're gonna debate about
loved.
That. Some.
Most.
Most, okay. But you know that there's a lot of controversial?
No.
Yeah.
Have you seen the videos? Everybody loves them.
Have you seen the comments?
Oh, whatever.
Okay.
You are listening to the 1% minority. I listen to the 99% majority.
So? Do you think so? It's like 1%?
No, I think it's 90%.
90% is that
support 10%.
Support 10% is
yes. Which is what is yours? It's 50%, 50%.
I'm 50-50 with you. I might change my opinion after I talk to you.
Okay.
Jadi kontroversinya adalah first because you're in Israel. You're from Israel, right?
So I am Palestinian, Muslim.
You're Muslim. You're Muslim,
Palestinian, Israeli.
But there's a controversy talking about that you don't have the religions.
Yeah, that's fake news.
Oh, that's fake news.
Yes.
So you're Muslim.
I was born and raised Muslim.
So up until now, you're Muslim.
Yes.
Oh, assalamualaikum.
Alhamdulillah, wa alaikum assalam.
Okay. So you're Muslims.
Okay. Yes. I don't pray. I'm not very religious.
But you're Muslim.
Yes, but okay. I'm Muslim.
But you're Muslim. Okay. So why do you think that people's talking bad things about you?
Oh, well, you know, there's a big saying that says, if a tree has a lot of fruit, it gets a lot of stones. Do you know that saying?
Yeah, I understand.
No, what I'm saying is like, look, I think what we've built, we've built this Nas Daily, Nas Company stuff, and we've built, we made a lot of videos and got 60 million followers. And because... You know, I don't have a filter, and because we make videos.
You're saying that because it's too big.
I mean, when you get to 60 million followers, you must have some enemies. You must have some haters.
Yeah, I know that.
I think it's natural business. Like it's kind of like every politician has like some lovers, some haters.
But I think they were talking about the Israel thing, isn't it? Because you're Israeli.
Yeah.
Is that the biggest problem?
I think that's the biggest problem.
That's the biggest problem.
Yeah, it's the thing that I cannot control. Can you control where you are born?
No, of course.
Yeah, so what if I hate you because you have a passport that you cannot control? I think it makes no sense. So people need to really not do that and really understand how complicated Israel and Palestine is. Mm. You cannot just hate everybody in Israel. That is stupid. And you cannot just hate everybody in Palestine. That is stupid.
Yeah, same things.
Exactly.
Yeah. So if I'm asking you, so I cannot ask which country that you support because I think you're, well, I can't ask that because I think you support peace.
So I support peace between Israel and Palestine. This is the videos that we make. And the problem is, do you support peace?
I support peace.
Yeah. So unfortunately, some people don't want peace. So they don't want to see peace.
No, and because they're saying there's a lot of history inside that peace is not the answer, probably. Yeah.
Well, exactly. So I think people need to understand that my family lives inside Israel. 20% of Israel is not Jewish. It is Palestinian Muslim. And so it's very complicated. It's not just like there's this country for Jews and this country for Muslims. It's like this.
And they're okay together.
Well, I mean, there's problems. It's not like there's no problems. There's problems every day. It's like in Indonesia, like in Singapore, there's problems everywhere. But yes, we live inside Israel.
You live inside Israel, but you're Palestinian, you're Muslim Palestinian.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. And but the problem, I mean, are they accepting you guys?
There are problems. We're not full, like we're not, let's say, equal. We're like I feel like a second class citizen, but I would much rather live in Israel than live in other countries.
Why is that?
Because there is opportunity. It's a developed country. There is jobs. There's freedom.
Okay.
So there's still some benefits to living inside. That's why my advice to anybody listening to this is to truly understand how complicated the conflict is.
Well, it is complicated. But some people they don't try to find the problem.
The solution.
They just see news.
But you know, Didi, if God forbid, let's say somebody says, "I want to destroy Israel," then my family dies. You know, my Palestinian Muslim family dies, right? So of course, I don't want Israel to be gone. I want Israel to succeed, and also I want Palestine to succeed because these are my people. I think the solution is two countries for two people living side by side in peace.
Do you think it's possible?
I think it's possible.
It's been years.
It's possible before we die. At least me.
Yeah, but that's not optimist words, though. Because there's hundreds of years, right?
So it's been 75 years.
Okay.
Okay, but I think the next 15 years, I think maybe peace will come in the next 15 years because of social media. Now you see that, oh my God, like we cannot just continue killing each other. We need a solution. And that will come in the next 15 years.
So you're a Muslim,
Palestinian.
Palestinian. Yes. You're a Muslim Palestinian.
Yes.
Living in Israel.
I used to.
Now you're in Dubai. Yeah,
Dubai.
Of course, yeah. Well,
everybody loves Dubai.
Everybody loves Dubai. Yeah. It's like another different world.
That's why I live in Dubai. Yeah.
So you're a Palestinian Muslim living in Israel as a Muslim, right?
Yes.
Okay. So is that Muslim over there? Are they free? Like they can do all their religions, rituals?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. There's 50 mosques in my city, village, whatever you call it. There's mosques. We go to mosques. We pray. It's an official religion in Israel. It's a recognized. So yeah, we do whatever we want.
So it's free. It's okay.
Yes.
And they guarantee your safety.
As a Muslim?
Yeah.
Yes. There's 2 million of us.
Muslim in Israel.
Yeah.
2 million Muslim in Israel.
Maybe 1.8, but yeah, you get the idea.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Did you not know that?
Well,
you don't hear about that.
I'm a podcaster and I need to.
But Didi, here's the thing. I don't want to come here and saying, "Hey guys, everything is fine between Israel and Palestine." It's not fine.
It's not fine.
And we need the Palestinians to have a state. But I'm here as a human. You know, that's why I wanted to come to Indonesia as a human. I have a new citizenship. I'm a Caribbean citizen as well.
You are a Caribbean citizen. How many citizenship do you have?
Two.
Two.
Did you know I wanted to come to Indonesia, but I can't, even though I'm Muslim, I cannot enter. So what I did, I bought another passport.
Uh-huh.
And I bought a passport, a Caribbean passport.
Uh-huh.
And now a Caribbean passport is okay. And now I'm here in my Caribbean passport.
So you cannot be here with your...
No, with Israeli, no.
Israeli, no.
No.
So you're here with Caribbean passport.
It cost me a lot of money to visit you.
Oh, yeah. No, because I thought that you came here with your original passport and it's okay.
No, you cannot enter. You have to be very special cases. Like you cannot enter. But I think Indonesians can apply to go visit Al-Aqsa in Israel and Palestine. So you can go, but I think it's difficult for us to come. But I don't know. I don't care. I don't care about this stuff. What I care about is, hey, let's make videos about Indonesia. There's a lot of cool videos, and let's show it to the world. We have more than 4 million followers in Indonesia. 2% of the country follows Nas Daily in Bahasa and English. Let's show them their country. That's why I'm here.
Yeah.
Forget my citizenship. Forget my history. Do you like the videos that you watch? Great.
Okay. Yeah, I can. I understand that. You know, this is what. Okay. Yeah. I understand that. But I think most of people they just don't care about that, and they just. They were born and teach different way.
Yes.
And it's difficult to explain. And I don't blame them. Because, you know, if you raise and you get an information like that, then I think it's fair, you know?
Yeah,
but,
true.
But talking about Indonesia, this thing, I watched your video about Bali.
Yes.
Yeah, the one that you say the widest island in Asia?
Question mark?
With a question mark.
Yes, there's a question mark.
Ah, there's a question mark.
Of course there's a question mark. Okay.
And but so the video...
Now it changes everything.
That's changed everything, yeah, of course. In the video, you say that this is white people. It's white people. But then in the video also, you show Indonesian Balinese.
Yeah,
that they say that they are very nice persons. They have great food.
They're welcoming.
They're welcoming, and you know, there's a lot of green grass everywhere, and the scooters, and it's a beautiful island.
It's a beautiful island.
That's why white peoples
and non-white peoples
are loved to visit Bali because of its beauty.
Yeah.
Right?
That's the message.
So
how bad is that as a message?
So why do you think people get it wrong? Because I watched the entire video.
And then?
And yeah, of course, the clickbait.
Yes.
Of course, there's always a clickbait, you know, but there's a question mark.
Yeah.
With cancel everything.
Making content is hard, man.
I know. Well, tell me about that, dude. But I watched the whole video. The first couple seconds, of course, if I don't know you, well, again, even I don't know you, I'm not going to judge things, you know, before I watch the entire video.
Yeah.
But there are people who just watch like clips and read news.
Yes.
Made up news, hoax and everything, saying that Mr. Nazir saying that Bali is white people's island. But after I watched the whole video, I said, no, this guy are telling that a lot of white people enjoying Bali and non-white people enjoying Bali because Bali is beautiful. Come to Bali.
Yes.
That's the message.
You get it.
Is that the message?
That is such a simple message, right?
That's a simple message, right? So why do you think you get hates? And even there is a like important person, people saying that you are shit.
No. It wasn't. They didn't say shit. I saw the post. They said, "Thank you for visiting Bali. We want to tell you that we like tourists, but we don't like tourists when they are not good with us. But when they're good with us, we like them." I think that's the message. So thank you for watching the video. I think it's everyone's responsibility. Before you make an opinion, you have to get the facts. And if you make an opinion before getting the facts, that's a you problem, right? That's your problem. And so we can't live our lives scared of people who don't read the facts. So the fact says, yes, everybody should come visit Bali because it's so beautiful.
Let me ask you things.
Yes.
After the videos viral about Bali, have you ever visited Bali anymore after that?
Yeah, I was in Bali then.
Sorry, the video out.
Yeah, I was in Bali.
you was in Bali.
Yeah.
When the controversy happened, are you in Bali?
Yes.
Yes.
They loved it.
And are they still accepting you?
They loved it. I met the royal family. They loved it. It's so funny.
That's funny then.
Because I think a lot of, here's my biggest problem with media. CNN, CNBC, BBC, whatever it is, they take the angry 5% and they make an article about it. And when you make an article about something, it makes it look real, right? Yeah. But it's still not real. It's still fake news. But when you make an article, it's like, so yes, maybe 5% are angry, not happy with it, 10%, 20%. But that is not the actual reality of it. 80% still support Nas Daily. People need to understand that.
You know, I'm sorry, but ini buat saya tadi baca berita, entah saya masukin. Deddy Corbuzier ikut-ikutan serang Bunda Korla dari Metro, ya. Ini goblok nih berita nih. Kapan gue nyerang Bunda Korlanya? Gue ngomong ke Pak Sandiaga Uno, gue ngomong Pak Sandiaga Uno tuh undang Bunda Korla, undang juga yang lain juga, yang juara matematika, juara apa, karena mereka bisa ngasih hal-hal positif. Di beritanya dibilang gue nyerang Bunda Korla. Ini dari Metro nih, nih ntar dekat captionnya ininya ditaruh nih. Tolol nih berita nih.
What happened? Your delivery? Your food delivery?
No, you know, there's influencers. Uh-huh. TikTok influencers, and she's very famous. She's stay in German, and then she visit Indonesia.
Yeah.
But her content is like entertainment, but saying bad words.
Yes.
But entertaining.
Yes.
You know, and then our minister, the same minister that Sandy? Having you, Sandy, yes. Invite. These girls to, I don't know. He invited or this girl come there, yes. but Sandy is very welcome.
Yes.
Okay. And in my podcast, I said, well, that's good.
Yeah.
That's good. When the call out there is good.
Yes.
But please, Minister, there is also Indonesians kids that just win world champion for physics and mathematics. I think you also need to invite them.
I see.
And in the news. I'm saying this because you're talking about the news, right?
Oh, okay.
And in the news, there's my face there saying, I hate Bunda Korla.
Who's Bunda Korla? Oh, the influencer.
The influencer.
Somebody needs to fix this.
See, there's a problem. I never say I hate her. I say it's good for her to come to Indonesia and our minister welcome her. But please, there's Indonesian people. That is win, just a couple months ago, we have two kids win world champion for physics.
I should make a video about them.
Yeah. And please invite them too. That's what I say.
I see.
And the news say that I hate Bunda Korla. That's stupid. That's news. Stupid. You're making that news are stupid.
This is his opinion, not mine.
Yeah, and all the things that he said is his opinions, not mine. Okay.
Both of you and I are going to be canceled tomorrow.
Okay, let's back to that. So news. Because bad news is a news, it's a good news. You know, people news, read the title, they don't really read the whole news.
Yes.
Like when you make a video of Bali, people probably just watch a couple seconds in the front and they don't care about the rest and just hit these people because it's okay.
I've been doing content for 7 years, right? I have stopped paying attention to the bottom 5% and the top 5%. Now I only care about the middle 90%.
Why you don't care about the top 5%? The top 5% is the one that like you, right?
Well, I mean, the left 5% and the right 5%.
Oh, okay.
Not the top
and
the bottom.
Not the top, the right and the left. Okay.
So the extremists, on either side, extremists who love the environment so much, they're like, I don't want to see a plastic bottle in your videos. Like this, I would not be allowed to show this. I'm like, I don't care about you. I will show a plastic bottle. And the bottom 5% and the left 5% is the ones that are like, you know, I don't like you because you are Muslim or because you are from Israel.
Yeah, you're talking about people who
yeah.
don't want to use a straw from a plastic.
Yes, that's the right 5%.
Paper.
Yes.
So they need to cut more trees.
So I see where you're going. But yes.
But we're not talking about that. We're not talking about that.
How many controversies can we cover in 10 minutes? So yeah, if you're thinking about the 90%, then we move on.
Yes, yes, yes. So basically, we need to move on and concentrate on what we do, and we believe what we do is good and not harm to people.
Yes, exactly.
And there are always people that like us very much, and people that don't like us very much. But we concentrate on it, and it's
exactly.
That is cut us down. You know, it's just bring down.
How many people like you, and how many people don't like you? By the way, like percentage. Today.
If you ask me that, I think 90%
today
people like me, 10% hates me.
Wow, that's a very high percentage.
Maybe. I said maybe. Okay, I don't know. I don't count.
So the real one is like 60-40?
Yeah, probably like 60-40. Like, okay, 70% like me, 30% don't like me.
70-30,
70-30, but...
I think same here.
But the thing is that 30% that don't like me are the one that talks a lot and write the captions, mentions on my Instagram and social media, where people that like me are like, they're quiet.
Yeah.
But, you know, I years ago, like 2-3 years ago, I changed the way I think. Because when I was young, well, that's like a long, long time ago. When you read people saying bad things about you, it's good to your mind. And it hurts.
Yeah.
And you keep on thinking about that. Like, shit. And you want to reply it. And, you know, you want to fight back.
Yeah.
And what happened is that when someone say bad things about me or you, then I gonna reply him, you know, with my opinions.
Yeah.
What I forget is that I don't quite reply people who like me.
Yeah, you take it for granted.
Yeah. So I think I need to change that. So I changed that. So now I reply people who support me instead of people who hate me. And there is also... a block button on Instagram, so spam restrict, you know.
You can also filter keywords.
Yes.
You do that?
Yeah, it's filter keywords. That's why I'm also part of the military. Mm-hmm. I have two different Instagram, and the military part I private.
You what?
So I make it private.
Private, okay.
Yeah, so when people want to join it, then I need to accept it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, because I don't want like everybody there. And it's going to be a mess.
That's interesting.
Yeah. So back again about Bali. Yeah. So you love Bali.
You've been, right?
Yeah, of course.
It's nice.
It is nice. Very nice people. It is nice. And cheap.
Yeah.
My kind of say cheap. For an expat.
For white tourists.
Yeah, for white tourists it's cheap.
That's what I said in the video.
Yes. Terus juga ada video dia di Indonesia tentang sebuah kampung yang nggak bisa mendengar. Nah, ini orang jarang tahu nih. I mean, you have a video about Indonesian village that cannot hear.
Yes, deaf village. A village with a very high percentage of deaf people.
Yeah, I don't think a lot of Indonesian people know about that too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, this is why we do what we do. I think Indonesia is full of incredible stuff and nobody knows about it. It takes somebody like us to come to that village, 4 hours drive, make the video, spend 15 hours on it, you know, lose money on it to tell you the story of the village. You know, and that's that we love doing that. We love doing that. So I think more people in Indonesia need to do that. You need to build your own Nas Daily. We need 100 Nas. Why are you waiting for this kid from the Middle East? You call him Israeli, you call him Palestinian. Why are you waiting? Get somebody in Indonesia to go and make that video so you know about that village.
So we know more about Indonesia.
Yeah, exactly. That's the goal. Don't you think?
Yeah.
That's the goal. Yeah. I should not be needed.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Yeah.
You're right. How did you get the information about all of this?
I researched.
You researched?
Yeah, so before I come to Indonesia, I have a team. We have a team of 40 people. And they're just like, wow, what is interesting about Indonesia?
40 people researched them.
So the people who did the research in Indonesia specifically is 5. And then we have another 10 who did NAS Summit. Mm-hmm. So we have a lot of people working on Indonesia right now. And we researched everything. And then I had 100 ideas. And I said, okay, good, boring, bad, boring, good, boring, 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 good. And then we found the top 7 interesting things about Indonesia. Mm-hmm. And we make the videos.
And you go to Indonesia for how long?
Just 1 week.
1 week. And you make like 7 videos.
7 videos.
That's crazy, man.
Every day, 1 minute. 1 week, and we pissed off so many people.
So, how you get the money from?
How I get the money from?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I know YouTube sponsors and everything, but if you go to Indonesia making a short or a reels, there's no money. There's no money in it.
And by the way, everybody thinks we're making money from these 1 minute videos. We're not.
No, we're not.
We're losing money.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, tell them. Every Instagram reel is money losing.
You know the YouTube have a YouTube Shorts?
Sorry?
YouTube Shorts, yeah. You know?
It started paying now.
Yeah, but you know how much is that?
It's like $10.
Yeah. I have one YouTube Shorts watch like 1 million people.
Yeah.
I got $6. What the?
Not enough for the cigarettes.
$6, bro. It's like, yeah. What the heck?
There is no money.
Jadi kalau orang-orang mikir banyak duit itu salah. Anyway, you know what? Forget about all of this controversy.
But by the way, we make money, to be clear.
Oh yes, of course.
Yeah, but not from the videos we're making in Indonesia.
Yeah. But also we make money. Here's the thing: if someone become a YouTubers and they don't have a crew, they're using their own camera, blah, blah, blah. They edit their own.
Yeah.
You know, you can make money from the AdSense.
Yes.
But if a company like you, well, the money needs to come from...
Somewhere else.
Yes. So it's not from the YouTube.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry for asking those kind of questions.
No, very good. Thank you for asking them. It's good to get it out of the way.
What I like about your video is because it's very informative, it's helpful, it's for young people who want to listen to it or watching it. You got a lot of good information. Actually, yesterday when I do the speech on the Nash Daily, which you don't understand what I said.
I don't understand what you said.
Yeah, I was just like, go mad on the...
Serotonin, dopamine.
Yeah. I'm telling them about how bad is social media impact your brain flow, your cognitive behaviors, blah, blah, blah. I'm saying bad things about social media in the first 50 minutes.
Yes.
And the last 5 minutes I say, but it depends on what you... choose and what you choose to see. Because my parents said, show me your friend, I can show you your futures.
Yes.
Now I can say that.
Show me your feed.
Show me your feed, I show you your futures. But your video is that things that bring a good hope for people who can learn. You know, you before you hear, I think my manager go to your hotel.
Yes, and
with his son.
He's very smart.
His sons love your videos. Yeah. And he learns a lot from your videos.
Do you think he was offended by the Bali video? He's the 90%.
Not that kid. We are not laughing about the Bali video. Yeah?
No, we're not laughing.
We are laughing about the kids. About the kids, yeah. Oh my God. This is not a problem.
But yes, I agree. This is why we make videos. This is not something to be like, I don't like being famous. It's nice to be famous, but I don't make this because it's money. It's because there is education. And 1 minute I can teach you something that I just learned.
You know what? I don't even have the power. I don't even have the energy to do that 1 minute video you made.
Why?
I'm almost,
you work out, you have a lot of energy to work out.
Man, how old are you?
I'm 30.
You're 30.
Ah, 31 now.
You're 30 now. I'm 47.
I mean, oh my God, you're 47?
I'm 47, yeah.
Wow, you
yeah.
look 35.
Yeah, but I'm 47, so I'm too old to make a video like that because I'm tired.
Yeah, that no, that's why you do podcasting. It's easy. Podcast. Just chat. Easy,
yeah. But no, really. I mean, to make a video, like your video in 1 minute, that's a lot of effort, times, thinkings.
Yes.
Managements, everything, and money to put into 1 minute videos to educate people that don't have a chance to go to that kind of place.
Right. Correct.
It's amazing.
Yes. I am very lucky that I have the energy. I'm very lucky. I get energy from people. I don't lose energy. I make energy from you. And that's why I like to be around people. And Nas means people in Arabic. So that's the whole point of Nas Daily.
That's the whole point of Nas Daily. One of the video that I watched from you is, like, I think, the last
two months.
It's about life without getting lucky.
How to live life without getting lucky.
How to live life without getting lucky. And in that video I watched, is you're talking about you, your life from a kid that don't have anything.
Yes.
And it's really connect to me because I born in a poor family and I need to start my own career.
Yeah.
You know, I was a magician.
Yes, I know that.
You know that, okay. I win a magic championship in Las Vegas twice in a row. Yeah. But that...
Why did you stop?
YouTube. Because YouTube now spreading all the secrets of magic. So magic is not magical anymore. If you
why you need to become a mentalist.
Yeah. But if I live in Vegas right now, I can still perform magic. In Indonesia, the culture of our people is not like they want to enjoy the magic. They enjoy the magic if they think it's real. You know what I mean, right?
So when, and also, but if you say it's real, you become satanic.
That's right. And if you say it's a trick, they're going to try to find the trick and they say that you're a liar. So
you can't win.
You can't win. But whatever. So I can feel it. I can understand when I watch your videos.
Yeah.
Tapi yang belum nonton ya, ini bagus banget videonya. So would you mind to explain me a little? Because I think there's a 5 points.
Yes,
5 points when you want to get success in your life.
Yes,
without getting lucky.
Yeah,
or without having the privilege.
Yeah.
Of doing that.
Yeah,
like you learning English.
Yes,
where it's not your language.
It's the most important thing.
Okay,
So the five things are this, right? So it's, if you want to live life today, you have to do these five. In my opinion, one, you have to accept. Accept that life is not fair.
Accept that life is not fair.
It's so unfair. You can work 10 hours and your friend works 1 hour and your friend...
And they get paid more than us.
Yeah. And that is so annoying, but you have to accept this is how the world runs. That's why an American has more money than an Indonesian average worker, right? It's unfair. Even though an Indonesian puts the same amount of time, right? If not more. So accept it's unfair. Then learn English.
Whoa, okay. Accept it that it's not, that is unfair.
Yeah.
Then learn English. Yeah. That's.
There's no connection.
There's no connection. I mean, if you accept it's not fair, then try to do something that make your life better.
Yes. So how do you make your life better?
First, why?
First, you cannot make your life better if you cannot speak.
Okay.
It's very simple. If I cannot talk to you, I will never give you opportunities. You will never give me opportunities, right? So that's why when I looked at my friends back in my Muslim Palestinian friends living in Israel, okay, they don't speak English. So they cannot get a job in America. They can only get a job in the village or in the city.
Mm.
That's a problem.
Why English?
Because English right now
is like the international language.
It's the only international language today.
It's the only international language. You know what? Sometimes I speak English when I do a podcast.
Yeah.
You know, it's just come out. Even with Indonesian, it's just come out. Sometimes my caption on Instagram, there are some English words there. And that 30% of people that don't like me saying that you are Indonesians.
You should speak Indonesian.
Should speak Indonesians, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
You know what? If I can't speak English, today won't happen.
Done, yeah.
Right? I won't understand whatever you say.
Yeah.
And there's we're not going to work together.
Ever.
Zero chance. So English.
Yes. So the number one, English. So I studied English by myself and at school when I was, you know, very young. To sound like this, I was not born like this. I worked for hours and hours to understand English.
Is that true that you bought the English dictionary?
Yes.
And then you read it?
Yeah, it's true. Start practicing, understand more, talk to friends on the internet. Then the next thing you have to do, if you truly want to succeed, is cancel your friends. I'm sorry, this sounds bad.
No, that's I say about that a lot of times, so no problem.
You said it, right? You're the average of the five people around you.
Yes.
The five people in your village that are around you today are not the right people. Because you are friends with your neighbors because they're your neighbors.
Yeah.
Not because you are connected.
No.
You're not meant for each other.
No.
So if you are a kid in Indonesia today, your soulmate is probably living in Malaysia. And another soulmate in Chicago. You need to find these five friends on the internet. So you should say goodbye to the ones around you because they're not going to lift you up, and surround yourself by people who will lift you up. So cancel your friends. That's really important. And find new friends.
Find new friends
which are better than you.
Okay.
Which are more successful than you. Not better, more successful than you.
I like this. You know, I wear Under Armour shirts, and one of the Under Armour have a word saying that the hardest worker in the room.
Yeah.
You know? And I wear that a lot. And then I realized that if I'm the hardest worker in the room, then I'm in the wrong room. Because there is no challenge anymore. We need to find someone smarter, like know better than us, and learn from them.
Yeah.
Is that what you mean?
That's exactly what I mean.
Okay.
You need to be the dumbest guy in the room.
Yeah, because then you learn.
Then you learn. By the way, I was the smartest, or second or third smartest guy in my high school.
In the wrong high school.
Then I went to Harvard, and I became the dumbest guy.
but that's when you learn, right?
It pushed me so much.
Yeah, of course.
So find new friends, and then
cancel
your friends, find new friends. And then I think you need to, in my opinion, learn skills that nobody else has, like magic. You succeeded, right? Because the reason you succeeded at the beginning is because not everybody could do magic. Your skill was unique.
Unpopular skill?
Not unpopular, but unique.
Unique skill.
Skill that's in high demand, but not enough supply.
High demand, but not enough supply.
Yeah.
For example.
If you know how to engineer with AI, you are a guaranteed millionaire.
These days, yeah.
Why is nobody learning this today? Yeah.
ChatGPT, dude.
Oh, insane, right?
Insane.
Also, even magic. If you know how to do magic, like you're entertaining, and if you're entertaining, you get attention. If you get attention, you get money. But you cannot just learn what school teaches you. That's the basic.
You cannot learn from what school teaches you.
And even
because
they
create the same products.
It's the same product for everybody.
For everybody. And it's wrong.
So what's the value then if everybody knows the same thing? You need to know something that other people don't know.
Yes. Skills.
That's the skill. And then, so that's number four, right? Mm. So accept life is unfair.
Learn English.
Learn English.
Cancel your friends.
Cancel your friends. Find new friends.
Find new friends.
Yeah, these are the same. And then learn new skills.
Learn new skills.
And the last one is the most offensive one. Leave your village.
You know what? Part of keys of successness are moving from your place.
Yes. I have a crazy story for you. You're Muslim. I'm Muslim. Okay?
Okay.
Islam started in Mecca, right?
Yeah.
And you know it was not accepted. Prophet Muhammad had to immigrate because Bani Quraysh, Bani Lahab, you know, all these people, they were like, what is this new religion? We don't like it. And we don't want you doing this. So Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, left Mecca to Medina. to go and tell them about Islam. And then the people in Medina said, yes, we like this.
Yeah.
So we'll become Muslims. And then he got more followers in Islam and then came back to Mecca.
Because they already accepted them.
Yeah. And they came back stronger. They came back
stronger.
Yeah. Because if you start anything in your village, you will not get support because you're one of us. We like the foreigners more than one of us. And so that's why you must be the foreigner in another place. You know?
But there's a lot of foreigner in another place that cannot get success.
Yes, yes. But immigrants are built, 80% of the biggest companies in America were built by immigrants. So immigrants are known, the immigrant community in London, I mean, they became the mayor. The mayor.
Yeah.
And so actually immigration is a good thing.
Yeah.
It's not a bad, we always think immigration, we think refugee, we think poor, we think, oh, but actually immigration is a great thing and we need more of it.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Even Arnold Schwarzenegger.
He immigrated.
He's originally from
Eastern Europe or something.
Yeah, Eastern Europe or something. He became a governor of Texas.
California.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
It's crazy, right?
Elon Musk immigrated.
Yeah.
Everybody immigrates. If I didn't immigrate from my village, I wouldn't be here. So that, I know a lot of people say, but I like my village. And you can go back and live in your village.
Yeah.
But your village
and
or
you
your
can
city
help people
more by
more
leaving.
More in your village when you become successful.
Yes.
So why do you think that? I think this is not a secret, right?
No, it's not.
I think people are teaching this. You know, even before you saying
of
this,
course.
Before I know this, like
yeah.
years ago, there's a books about that, like yeah. Robert Kiyosaki, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, saying that, get out from your house, you know, you know, and Tony Robbins saying.
Yeah, but yeah. They didn't make a video about it and put it on Instagram.
It. Yeah.
It's the same message, different packaging.
Yeah, and you know, people now, they don't read the books anymore.
They don't read books.
They read books and they don't read books. But why do you think that even people know this,
they don't do it?
Yeah.
You know how selling works, right? Like Tokopedia. You have to show the audience Tokopedia like 100 times until they get convinced to use it. 100 times. Tokopedia, Tokopedia, you know?
Yeah.
Similarly, you need to hear the same message 500 times to finally leave your village. And leaving your village is not easy. You need money. You need support. You need planning. I mean, it's not. It's like me asking somebody to jump off their home into the unknown. It's scary. I think that's why it's scary.
So when you get out from this, you're like, family agree?
Yeah, because I got into Harvard.
Oh yeah, of course.
So it's like, get out, bye.
Yeah, yeah, Harvard, yeah.
But even if I went out to Germany or to other countries, they would have said, yeah, go, leave.
You know, not all family.
Yeah. That's how I'm lucky.
The poor mindset family. This is what's funny. You know, poor mindset family and economy. They don't want their sons to go out from their house.
Yeah. So that's why I made that video. Take that video, send it to your dad. Send it to your mom. But I think parents don't read books. Many parents don't read books. They're like giving up. Like, I'm never going to change my opinion. So that's why a young population needs to create media content to convince the old population.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like around like 5 years ago or probably more, 7 years ago, I make one video. It's not video. It's, you know, before... There's an applications, I forget the applications. It's not Spotify, but basically you record
Clubhouse.
Not Clubhouse, oh. Before Clubhouse. This is 8 years ago.
Oh, wow.
I forget what it is. So basically all you can do is just record your voice and then send it to it and then they spread it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I forget the application, but there is an application like that. Apa ya itu dulu ya? SoundCloud.
SoundCloud, yes. I know SoundCloud.
I think SoundCloud. Yeah, SoundCloud.
Still around.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So I'm just pitch saying about school is not important. Education is.
Mm, okay. Yeah.
Then I'm saying a lot of wrong thing in the school, you know, like blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
And after that, it becomes very popular.
Yeah.
some people hate me. Of course, the parents hate me. The kids love me. The teachers get confused because it's spread all Indonesia.
Yeah.
And 2 years ago, you met Nada. Nada is my daughter.
Yes.
Yesterday, this is basically my what you call this. It's not a dot, but it's foster.
Foster daughter.
Foster daughter.
Like, what is that? Like she lives with you for a period of time.
No, she lives with me because I'm basically helping her for a lot of things,
yeah.
And now it's become family. She called me dad now,
okay.
And she stay with us a lot of times. And she's already my daughter. Basically, she's my daughter.
Makes sense.
She said, when she don't go to school, she said, I don't go to school because I'm listening to your words, dad.
Yeah.
But I'm, up until now, I'm still saying that school is not important. School, I'm not talking about university.
Hmm.
Not important because the way they teach in school need to be changed.
Yes. Yeah.
Need to be changed. School doesn't teach you for teamwork. School doesn't teach you what... They teach you to save money. They don't teach you to make money.
Yeah.
And a lot of things. And they teach you something. I don't even agree with the homework. You know, if you give a homework for kids, means you don't teach well. Because you need to test that the kids understand it or not.
Yeah.
Everything I say is controversial about the school.
I mean, you see people graduate from school and the school teaches them English and then they graduate and they can't speak English. That's the number one evidence,
isn't it,
that it doesn't work.
That's right?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know how I can speak English?
Movies?
Magic.
Magic?
Magic.
Really?
Yes. Because when I was like in a junior high schools, they teach English, right?
Yeah.
But this is a cat, this is a dog. You know,
eat,
you know, that kind of English. Because by that time, when I was a kid, English is non-popular, but they need to teach the kids. So forget about that. And then my parents put me in English course.
Mm-hmm.
So I go there like twice a week learning English. Doesn't work for me. Doesn't work for me. And then I get interested in magic.
Mm.
The problem is, all the magic books
are in English. Great.
So I have to buy dictionary, magic books, open dictionary, write it down with Indonesian language one by one.
Wow.
That's how I learn English.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
So that's a great reason.
Yeah, yeah. So, but I think English is very important.
Yeah.
Very important.
Yeah, and the reason I'm sad today speaking to you is that we're speaking in English.
And a lot of the audience
is going to be like, skip.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I don't know. I think we need to put a subtitle here.
That's going to take hours.
You know, is there a machine for doing that? Right? Yeah, we have a machine for that, right? We bought that. We subscribed to it, right? Yeah, I think so. Well, we'll talk about it later. I think this is need to be transcribed.
Translate.
Yeah. Because otherwise, people are just going to hate us. Hate us with no reasons. And in English language, just add more reason for them to hate us. You speak English, you don't put... But that was Jakarta, bro.
Jakarta, I saw nothing.
You're tired, isn't it? You've been 7 days in Jakarta.
7 days? 1 day? 2 days?
Yesterday you say you're here for...
No, I was in Bali for 6 days.
Oh, you're in Bali for 6 days,
yeah.
And you're in Jakarta.
I just arrived 2 days ago. So I haven't seen anything. I just saw Jakarta by coming to your office.
The way...
look nice, buildings. So unfortunately, I don't have time to see it, but I saw the people of Jakarta with NAS Summit. We just had it for the first time here, and it was a lot of fun.
Yeah,
800 people. I met you. I mean, it's so fun. It's fun.
Yeah,
I love the energy.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
Yeah.
You like Indonesian food?
I do.
Have you tried Indonesian food?
I do. I normally don't care about food, but because I'm vegetarian.
Are you vegetarian?
Yeah. So I love tempeh and tahu.
Okay.
That's my favorite thing about Indonesia, to be honest.
Vegetarians eat fish?
No.
No.
For 57 years, how do you ask this question?
No, there's a lot of vegetarian style.
It's called pescatarian.
Oh, pescatarian, that eat fish. Okay. You eat egg?
Yes.
Egg. But there is a vegetarian that don't eat
it's
egg.
It's called vegan.
Oh, God. What the heck
it's
is
easy.
This?
It's four words.
It's
vegan, vegetarian, pescatarian, and a person who eats dead animals. You.
So vegan,
yes.
They don't eat meat
or eggs or milk.
Living things. Vegan.
Vegan. Yeah, but the hardest, very hard.
Vegan is the top of the chain.
Top of it. Actually, no. There's another one on top. It's called fruititarian.
They don't eat anything?
Fruititarian.
So they only eat fruit?
Yeah.
No way.
Yes.
There it is.
It's a real thing. Yeah.
You made it up.
No,
fruit,
check it out.
Fruit what?
Fruititarian, something like that. Double check.
I just heard this.
But it is very, very rare. And it's crazy as well.
It's like a Buddhist monk, something like that?
I don't know.
I think Buddhist monk eat vegetables.
Yeah, fruitarianism. It's a diet that consists of only eating fruits, nuts, and seeds, but without any animal products. But these are subject to health concerns and criticism. This is not mainstream.
Okay. You know, there is anorexia. There is there's an orthorexia.
What's that?
People who care too much about what they eat.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah.
That's orthorexia.
Yeah, orthorexia.
That's
so they need to to put exactly how many calories.
Well, that's you. To get to that body, you had to do that.
Yeah, but this is so crazy. It's like the calorie combined with the vegan combined with, like you need to eat fruit for,
To be clear, every bodybuilder is crazy about food. Every person who looks like you is not born like that.
Crazy, probably.
You have to macro, micro, protein, carbs, fat. I'm trying to do this and it's too crazy for me.
Yeah. So milk, dairy, vegan, no.
No, vegan, no. So then vegetarian.
Vegetarian.
Milk is okay.
Milk
egg is
okay.
Okay.
Egg is okay.
Very easy. Then pescatarian.
Pescatarian.
Milk, egg, and fish.
Fish is including everything on the sea?
Everything fish. Shrimp, fish, everything.
So everything on the sea.
Yeah.
Crabs?
Crabs, yeah, okay.
Okay.
Yeah. And then there is carnivore, which is you.
Yeah.
Eat
and
everything.
Why you become a vegan?
Vegetarian.
So
confusing.
Wait. Vegetarian, so you eat egg, right?
Yes.
You eat egg and milk.
I eat a lot of eggs.
You eat a lot of egg, yeah, for protein. You're vegetarian, so why you become vegetarians?
Because if you give me a knife now, if you give me a knife, a real knife, and you give me a cow, I cannot put the knife in the cow.
You're not the one that put the knife on the cow.
No, but I cannot do it myself.
Yeah.
I do not want to.
Yeah.
And as looking at the cow, I was like, don't kill me. And I'm like, die. I was like, wait a minute. Why did I just eat this thing? And you know, one of my biggest childhood memories is Eid al-Adha.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So we were celebrating, my family celebrated Adha. And then we brought this goat, a sheep, and then we did this at the neck. And then my uncle or something did this. And the whole blood was like, right in front of me.
Are you trying to make me vegetarian? So?
No, I'm just telling you what happened to me. So I decided that, you talked about hypocrisy before.
Yeah.
It's like, you said, oh, I myself cannot kill a cow and eat it. But if somebody else kills it and gives me the food and cooks it, I will eat it. But it's like A equals B equals C.
Yeah.
So A equals C.
Yeah.
So I decided from now on, I only want to eat what I am willing to kill, what I'm willing to do myself.
Oh, well, that's a nice thing.
So I don't care about health. I don't care about that. I just don't like this idea. And also, there's a lot of the shrimp is the bug in the ocean. It's a bug.
Yeah.
It has these things. I don't like bugs. It's weird. It's weird. It tastes amazing, but it's weird. No?
Okay.
You love meat. I look at your body. I mean, look, I see this. If I give you a knife now, would you put it in the cow's neck?
No, I don't think so.
What? What do you mean you don't think? Come on, you have to.
Oh, yeah, someone else can do that. No, I get your point. What about fish?
There's a research that
fish don't feel pain.
So, in 5 years, I may start eating fish.
Why?
Because I am okay with taking a fish from the ocean. I'm okay with it.
You're okay with it?
Yeah, I can take a fish. It's a little bit of pain, but whatever. Like, I'm okay with that.
Okay.
So, but I'm not okay with killing a cow.
Because there's research about that fish, they don't have that pain.
Yeah.
Things like that. And you cut it, it's not blood, like not a lot of blood.
Something like that. Or, I mean, I'm willing to listen to that. Yeah. Do you have a cat?
I have a dog.
You have a dog? Do you like your dog?
I don't know where this is going.
I don't know.
Since when is it?
3 years now.
3 years?
Yeah. It's fresh.
Wait a minute. So you say when you were a kid, you see that it's make a traumatic itself.
And I still ate it.
But why is it starting 3 years ago?
My partner, she's vegetarian for 12 years.
Okay.
And every time we went to dinner together, she orders vegetarian and I order meat.
Okay.
And then I taste my meat and I taste the vegetarian food and I always liked it more. I liked her vegetarian food more.
No way.
Yeah, I liked it more.
Really?
Yeah, I was like, oh, this is delicious. I thought vegetarian is boring. And so after hundreds of times, we said, let's just become vegetarian. Call it a day.
Really? Not because of your girlfriends.
No, no, not because, but I also, even if I'm not with her, I still am vegetarian. But she introduced these ideas to me. You know what I mean? But also another thing, science now is making fake meat, right? You can make, like at the summit, we had meat, but it was made from soybeans, tempeh.
Yeah.
And it tasted just
as good. I know. I tried that before. You cannot tell the difference.
You can't. So in the next 20 years, every
there's a
meat,
fake meat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is the future.
You don't have to kill. Yeah. I have a question for you.
Yes.
A hypocrite one. How about your shoes?
Excuse?
How about your shoes? Your wallet?
Yeah.
It's a skin.
No, it's not skin.
From that animal.
No, no. I also don't do leather.
You don't do that.
Yeah, but nice one. Nice try.
I didn't get you.
He thought he was so smart.
Yeah, I got him. No, really?
Of course, no leather.
Ah.
No leather.
They're better, you know?
Now, I do wear cotton, right? Cotton is okay. If you give me a sheep now and a razor, of course, let's get the sheep.
No problem with that. Yeah.
Yeah. And a milk, if you give me a cow, let me do the milk, milk, it's okay.
They probably enjoy it, so it's okay. So no skin leathers?
No suffering.
No suffering.
No pain.
No pain.
I don't want pain. I don't want to create more pain. Not in Israel, not in Palestine, not with animals, not with humans. I just don't want to create pain. That's it.
I love you.
Thank you.
Beautiful brother. Well, I need to stop this because otherwise...
You'll become vegan. Fruitarian.
My mind is pedestrian. Oh, say it again. The one that did fish.
Which one?
Fish one.
Pescatarian.
Pescatarian.
Yeah.
Pescatarians.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I think I can be pescatarian. I kind of live with fish, love seafood. So, which country you go after this?
Dubai.
Dubai. But you just go home then, basically.
I'm going home, yeah.
Going home.
Going home, baby.
And after that?
That's it.
What do you mean, that's it?
then maybe I'll come back to Indonesia. We'll see. But there's now summits in Dubai. We're doing one in Los Angeles, New York, London. So we're traveling to the West.
So if you go...
We're going to the white people countries.
You go to the white people. If you do the nice summit with a lot of effort like that, so who do the feed you? You spend time... to make videos.
My team now is 100 people, so they help me. They're amazing. They help me with everything. Not summit, the videos. We build things together.
Okay, okay. So, okay. So the video is still on.
No, video's on.
Video's on.
Video's on.
So babe. I can see you on the videos.
You see you in the videos.
Okay, mate. Thank you very much.
I really enjoyed this, man.
I really
enjoyed this. It's so nice to chat with you. You're very easy to converse with. And also, no judgment. It's nice.
Well, I don't think I have the right to judge, you know?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
People have their different opinions and we need to listen, because if you don't listen to people's opinion, we never learn.
Yeah.
And I know this is going to make a controversy because, you know, inviting you here are loving.
No pain.
No pain. Well, you need to catch a plane, right?
Yes.
Thank you. So I'm going to see you again soon, probably if I go to Dubai. So.
Yeah, please come find me in Dubai. I'd love to host you.
You know what? You're busy. You're busy.
No.
Ass.
Not for you. For you, I'm free.
You're busy. You have a car in Dubai?
Yes.
More than one?
No, one.
Oh, shit. Okay.
I heard you have 10 cars.
Yeah, but if I go to Dubai,
you need a car,
you know, I can just say, I don't need to meet you, but
I want your Ferrari.
I need to borrow your car. I see you again, mate. Thank you very much for coming. Let's close this.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And close the door.